Hi everyone. So today we will discuss about organic nomenclature. This is one of important topic in intermediate first year. So IUPAC means International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. It is very systematic nomenclature. What is IUPAC nomenclature? Why these IUPAC nomenclature rules are introduced in chemistry? We will discuss later. Okay, first nomenclature part divided into three parts: root word, suffix, and prefix. Okay, every organic compound name comes under these three categories only. Okay, first one is root word. Root word indicates the what? Root word indicates the number of continuous carbons present in the main or parent chain. Okay. Number of continuous carbons. For example, the compound having C1. The compound having one carbon. The root word is meth. If the compound having two carbons, eth. Compound means organic compound or organic structure. Okay, given organic structure having three carbon continuous carbons. Okay, prop C4, for example, C4 1 2 3 4. So this compound having four continuous carbons, so the root word is bent. If the compound having C5 pent, C6 hex, C7 hept, C8 opt, C9 non, C10 dec. Up to your syllabus 10 is enough. If you want, you can read more. The compound having 11 carbons, 12 carbons, there is also nomenclature. But as of your syllabus, 10 is enough. Okay. Then primary suffix. Are you understood? First one, root word. Root word indicates the number of continuous carbons present in the organic compound. Okay, then primary suffix, it indicates the nature of the main carbon chain. Nature means what the compound, given organic compound having single bond. If the compound having single bond or double bond, single bond means like this, double bond or triple bond, like this. Okay, so primary suffix mainly indicates the compound having which type of bond is present. So if the compound having single one, so that is called saturated compound. Only single bond is present in between two carbons, that is called single bond. So suffix is an. Suffix is an. If the compound having double bond or triple bond, that is called unsaturation. If the compound having double bond or triple bond, whatever the compound having double bond or triple bond. So if the compound having only double bond, that is in. Primary suffix is in. If the compound having unsaturated with the triple bond, unsaturated means if the compound, having must ensure one double bond or one triple bond, whether one double or one triple bond, whatever the compound having, but triple bond is present, that is iron, alkyne, iron. Okay, understood? Then secondary suffix. It indicates the main functional group in the compound. So, for example, the compound is alcohol. Just imagine the compound is alcohol. Symbol is OH. For example, CH3OH. This is the functional group. Okay, So, alcohol, this is alcohol group and this is the symbol. OH group. If this type of compounds occurred in the examination, So we use secondary suffixes ol, alcohol, alcohol. Just remember ol here, ol, 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 ol. Okay, just remember. Next, aldehyde, aldehyde. For example, CH3, C double bond OH. This is the aldehyde group. CHO, aldehyde group. If the compound having aldehyde group, so we use secondary suffixes AL, all, AL, all. Okay. Next, ketone, ketone. If the compound having C double bond OH, this is the keto group. So ketone, ketone. This is the symbol of ketone, and we use secondary suffixes ON, O-N-E, ON. Okay, O-N-E, ON. Right, clear? Right. Next one, carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. So symbol is COOH. So secondary suffix is oic acid, right? Then amine, amine, amine. 1 minute, right? Amine, amine, and NH2. NH2 is the symbol, and secondary suffix is amine, amine. Just sulfonic acid, sulfonic acid. SO3H. So secondary suffix is sulfonic acid. And cyanide, the symbol is CN. So secondary suffix is nitrile. We use nitrile as a secondary suffix. Then isocyanide, NC. Here cyanide, CN. Isocyanide, NC. Carbylamine. Then ester, C double bond O O R, C O R. Oid, ester is oid. Azyl halide, COX, halide means halides, X. Okay, well, halide. Acid amide, C double bond O, NH2, amide. Anhydride, C double bond O, OC, oic anhydride. If you want to write this total structure, please pause it and write down and again listen. Okay, right. Next one is prefix. What? Prefix. This prefix is used in cyclocompounds. Always use cyclo. This prefix is used in cyclocompounds. For example, this is the compound. Okay, triangle shape. Just imagine this is the one carbon, this is the one carbon, this is the third carbon. So always 1, 2, 3, three carbons are present. 3 means here, 3 means what is the root word of the having compound 3 carbons? Prop. Okay, prop. Okay, so as for primary suffix, single bond are present or double or triple bond present. So only single bond present means alkane. This is propane. Then we use, this is in cyclic form. So we always use cyclo. So cyclopropane. So we take another example. This is four carbon structure. So how many carbons are there? Four carbon. Four means bit. So all are single ones. Means in. Okay. Butane. So this is in cyclic form. So we use cyclo. Okay. So the name is cyclobutane. Cyclobutane. Clear? Next, secondary prefix. It indicates the substituents are secondary grade functional groups present in the organic compound, given organic compound. Substituents are secondary grade functional groups attached to main carbon chain. Or if the compound having X means halo compounds, halogens. Okay, halogens means fluoro, chloro, bromo, iodo. These compounds are attached to main carbon chain. We use halo. Okay, next C double bond O. This is keto group. Keto group. So secondary suffix is oxo or keto. Next R means alkyl group. If the compound having alkyl group, we use alkyl name as the secondary prefix. OR alkoxy. R means listen. R is one methyl group or one ethyl group. Any R propyl, butyl, pentyl, hexyl, heptyl, octyl, and like this. Okay. OR means alkoxy. Cyano, CN nitrile, cyano, ester, COOR, alkoxy carbonyl, next COX, halocarbonyl. This is R group. R means alkoxy carbonyl. Here X is present. Halocarbonyl. Likewise, NH2, amino, nitro, NO2, nitro, NO, nitroso, C double bond OH, keto. Keto means formyl. We use formyl as a secondary suffix. OH, hydroxy, SO3H, sulfur, C double bond O, NH, carbonyl group. Okay. You please remember, these all are important structures to write the organic compound. Okay, please, if you want to write, pause it and write down and listen again. Okay, if you are interested this organic compounds, one by one we will discuss later what is the rules to write the organic nomenclature and what type of organic compounds present in your syllabus. Okay, we will discuss later. Thank you. Bye. See you.